Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this set of videos, you'll learn about a new workflow to instantly exchange 3D data between Flame, Maya, and Mudbox. With the Flame 2020.3 update, as well as the Maya and Mudbox 2020 release, it is easier than ever to move a 3D dataset between these applications without the need for manual exporting and importing, as well as maintain a connection between the applications to monitor the development of a 3D asset. This is known as the Send To workflow, and it opens up a ton of creative and technical capabilities for any Flame artist working with 3D assets. For example, if you're in Flame and you need to sculpt, texture, or retopologize a 3D model, you could use Mudbox. Or perhaps you need to do some general 3D work, like modeling, UV manipulation, camera, lighting, and animation, so you would choose Maya. There are many practical use cases, such as pack shot work, previs, fast PBR integration with live action, cleanup work, and so much more. Essentially, the purpose of this interoperability is to expand beyond what you can do with the Flames toolset. Now, this is a single system workflow. This means that the Flame 2020.3 update, Maya 2020, and Mudbox 2020 must all be on the same workstation in order for this to work. If you are using multiple workstations, you will need to resort to manually exporting and importing FBX datasets in order to work on separate applications on separate workstations, and no direct connection can be maintained between the applications. So this workflow can expand your capabilities, but it's limited to your creative workstation. Now the good news is that the Send To workflow works on both Linux and macOS. As always, please check the Flame documentation for any steps you need to follow in order to set up the workflow between the applications. So let's look at the basic workflow, and then we'll expand this further by exploring a couple production scenarios. Now currently, Flame is the foreground application, but I also have Maya and Mudbox running in the background. This is not necessary, as Flame can launch these applications. However, since they are already running, this will bypass any messaging or startup screens as you send data between the applications. As a tip, Maya and Mudbox can also launch Flame. However, this will only get you as far as the Flame splash screen, and you would have to manually start your project. So if you do start a 3D job in Maya or Mudbox, make sure you have Flame running first, and in the right part of the application before sending any 3D asset. This will become clearer as you see the data exchange between the applications. So starting in batch, I have just imported a background image and connected that into a fresh Action 3D compositor. Switch to a 2-up view and look at the action schematic in one view and the result view in the other. I'm not using the manager in this instance, as the action schematic shows all the objects in the 3D composite and how they relate to each other. This will make it easier to understand how the interoperability works from Flame's point of view. Now, this could be a simple composite or a complex composite full of objects, but let's import a 3D object to illustrate the workflow. Either using the node bin or context menu, choose the import option. Now go into the FBX folder. At this moment, I would like to point out that you have two types of 3D geometry included with the pre-installed FBX models. You have models with quad polygons, where each face of the model has 4 points, and models with triangle polygons, where each face of the model has 3 points. These are the basics of 3D modeling, and all the applications can work with both types. The reason for having both options is that it is preferable to work with quad polygons in Maya and triangle polygons in Mudbox. It's not a major issue, even if you have been supplied with an external model, but you may need to do extra steps in either Maya or Mudbox to work with these particular models. Since you'll be using Maya to get the basic steps down, go into the PBS Quads folder and choose the Ring 3D model. Now let's light this with an IBL map to make it look better. Select the camera node and add an IBL through the context menu. Go to the IBL controls, choose the Read File menu, and load the mtlab.exr texture as the lighting for the 3D model. If you grab the model, scale it up, and rotate its x-axis, you can spin it around in 3D space. To play around with the look of the texture, go to the shader node and adjust the metallic and roughness properties. You can obviously do a lot more with this in Flame, but let's say you wanted to do a bit of remodeling using Maya. To send this 3D geometry to Maya, select the Geom node in the schematic. This workflow is selection sensitive, so make sure you choose the correct object in the 3D composite. With that said, please be aware that when you send the selected Geom node to Maya, the transformations of the parent axis are included. So any transformations you make here will be interpreted in the other 3D applications. If you wanted to keep your transformations in Flame but not send them to Maya, add another axis as the parent of the existing one and make your transformations there. The original axis will have no transformations, and that's what you'll get in Maya. Just a handy tip to remember. Now with the geometry node selected, call up the context menu and choose the Send to Maya menu. Please note, you will not see the options if you are not running the correct versions of the applications. Now there are a couple of options, but since there is no existing Maya scene for the 3D geometry, choose Send Selected as New Scene. Flame connects with Maya, and the selected geometry node with its parent axis node are sent across. If you switch to Maya, you'll be asked to save the current scene, which you don't need, and a new 3D scene is created with the geometry from Flame. You can press A to frame all the 3D objects, and you can hold Alt and rotate around the 3D scene. Please note that since you only selected the geometry node, only the geometry and its transformations are imported into Maya. There are no textures on the model unless you had selected the texture maps as well before using the Send To options. As a tip, if you had used any procedural textures like Substance PBR, these would be converted into image maps for Maya since no procedural texture maps are supported with this workflow. This can easily be restored in Flame if necessary. Now, since you are in Maya, you have all these 3D tools at your disposal. You'll cover some of these tools over the coming videos, but I suggest watching the Maya Learning channel to pick up some of the basics of working in Maya. For now, you'll just perform a couple of extrusions. Select the model and switch to the Modeling Toolkit. Switch the selection mode to the faces selection. Now zoom into the model with the middle wheel of the mouse and select one of the polygon faces. If you hold shift and double click on the face next to it, it will perform a loop selection around the ring. Repeat these steps to select another loop of faces. Once you have your selection, click the extrude button and using the visible axis, drag out the extrusion. You can see how you have added more detail to the ring, but the extrusion faces are harsh. So click the bevel option and you can bevel the edges to make it look a lot better. So you can see that we have changed the state of the ring geometry, which is not something you can do in Flame. Now let's say that you're happy with this and you would like to go back to Flame. Well, you have a couple of options, but I'd like to point out that if you look at the bottom right of the screen, you can see that Flame is actually connected to Maya. You could click the update button here or via the file menu. Before you do that, I did mention that the workflow is selection-based, but equally important, the workflow is name-based as well. Looking in the Maya Outliner, which is the equivalent of the Flame Manager and Action Schematic, you can select the geometry to send back to Flame. The name of the 3D model is identical to the 3D Geom node in Action. If the name was different and you sent this back to Flame, it would add a new 3D object with a different name instead of updating the existing one. So naming consistency should be maintained throughout the workflow. With the object selected, click the File menu and go to Send to Flame. You could send as a new scene, which would create a new Action 3D composite with this geometry, or you could add the geometry to the current scene. This would make a new 3D object in the current action. In this case, choose Update Current Scene, which is the same as pressing the button at the bottom right, and this will update the current 3D geometry in action. When you switch back to Flame, you will see that the schematic is exactly the same as before, but the current Geom node has been updated with the modified 3D geometry. If you select the axis and rotate the 3D object, you can see the modifications that were done in Maya, and the same texturing in Flame is now applied to the new 3D object. You can now carry on developing the composite and finish integrating your 3D object. At any time, if you wish to go back to Maya to make more modifications, you can just switch back to the existing Maya scene and alter the geometry. You would then update the connection to Flame, and the change would appear in the Action composite. If you had closed Maya or the 3D scene was no longer available, simply select the Geom node in Flame and send it again as a new scene. So you can round-trip the 3D data as many times as you like, and as long as you maintain the selection and the name of the geometry, this should work quite well. So this should be enough to get you started on the interoperability workflow. But in the next video, we'll take a look at how the interoperability works with Flame and Mudbox, and we'll discuss more about polygons, sculpting, painting, and more. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2020.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Thanks for watching and hope to see you soon.